this is Joy from Enjoy Fitness 43, and we're going to be doing a weighted workout today. But you're also going to need a band. So if you have a circle band, that's the kind of band that we need today for our workout, and you need two weights. We'll be doing three different workouts. We're going to start with a warm-up, so grab water, a band, and we're going to get ready with our warm-up. So here we go. So we're going to start with just a little step outs from side to side. So we'll get used to that because that's going to be part of one of our exercises that we're going to do later. So breathing and nice little step outs. Working on that outer thigh. Just trying to get a little bit further with each step. Okay, now we're going to take it back, making sure that you're going behind each shoulder and not crossing over. We'll get to that later with a different exercise. Good, keep going, almost there. Nice, easy steps going back. Okay, let's use our arms. We're just going to swing our arms up and back. That's it. Nice, easy swing. So pay attention to your mobility of your arms. Maybe you can only go this high. Okay? So do what you can with your mobility. Okay, we're going to take one arm back, and we're going to use a rotation with our whole body, going round and round. That's it. Lifting that heel as I go around, make sure I get a full rotation, really warming up that shoulder and the upper back. Okay, so shake it out. Let's do the other side. Good. And of course, maybe you have one shoulder that's easy to move and the other shoulder's not as easy to move. So do what you can in each shoulder. Maybe you have to take the other shoulder down a little bit more. And you have to think about full range of movement though. So if you can't get that other shoulder all the way up, you have to think about the full range of movement though, because hopefully you'll be able to get the full range of movement someday in that shoulder. Almost there, a few more seconds. Because we always want to become whole in our movements. Alrighty, so we're going to take our legs, we're going to go in and out from each side, crossing over the opposite knee line, and then bringing the knee up hip height, rotating out through the hip. That's it. Making sure we work through the hip and the pelvis. Waking up all of the joints and the muscles in that area. Good. Keep going. That's it. Keep moving. Breathe, breathe, breathe for me. So we're going to take a side lunge, nice and easy, to the other side, good. Okay, now let's turn it out just a little bit more, good. We're really trying to get into that hip and inner thigh. And we're going to just go ahead and rotate here for a second, side to side. to kind of whack my waistline while I'm doing this one. Side, and that is it. Okay, so that's all of our exercises for our warm-up exercises for this, and we're going to set our timer off to the side. Okay, so our first set of exercises we're going to start with are going to be with the band. So get yourself a drink of water, and then we're going to put the band on. If you do not have a band, don't fret. I'm going to show you how to use a weight to help you do these exercises, or you don't have to use a weight or a band at all. So we're gonna start with the band right above the knees if you have the band. If not, you're going to go ahead and put the weight on the outside of the leg, okay? We're gonna just bend over, we're gonna hold the leg here, hold the leg here, hold the weight here, okay, to add just a little weight on it. So don't like hold it in your hand way out here. It's going to lean up against the leg so that you are pushing the weight away, okay? If you want to use a weight to add a little resistance. So I'm going to make sure my timer is where I want. Okay, this is a 12-minute workout. So we're going to make sure we have our 12 minutes. Okay, so you're going to bend over just a little bit. So we're going to bend the knees a little tiny bit. So straight, bent. Tip over just a little bit to ignite the tush, okay? 15 seconds of rest, 45 seconds of work is what we're gonna do. We're gonna take the right leg out first, and all we're gonna do is we're gonna tap out to the side, and that band is gonna add extra resistance, or the weight is gonna add extra resistance. Or if you don't have either, or don't want to use that weight, then you're just gonna tap out to the side. And this bending over and the knees bent are gonna help ignite this tush, and and pushing out to the side is gonna work this muscle right here on the outside of the leg, okay? Because we're always looking to work on slimming those thighs, working those muscles. So working that muscle is gonna help work building a leaner muscle in the leg and burning fat, okay? So we're gonna do that for 45 seconds. Perfect. Okay, now we're gonna just do the other side. Make sure you always have tension in the band. Don't bring it so close together that you don't have tension. Okay, shoulders down and back, tush out, knees bent. Okay, we're gonna tap out the other side. Good. Going to the other side. We're going to do two rounds. We have six exercises. That's it. Good. That's it. Reach out. Reach out as far as that. So don't do this little tiny tap. Let's take that leg out there. Do it with some force and some quickness. You can use your arms to really help you get that leg out there like you're running. All right, so now that's front and back. So now we're gonna take a step out, bring it in, take a step out and bring it in. So we're gonna squat both times. Alrighty. And so we step out, squat, in, squat. Out, squat, in, squat. Good. And keep going. So of course, we want to go as low as we can. You gotta think about those knees. Knees are following toes as we squat. Good. Keep going. Good job. Knees follow toes. Okay, whew. Good job following, okay? take a leg back, and we're gonna do a nice split squat. Okay, take it back, lunge, split squat. Okay, good. That's it, good. Job. Taking it back. Push back on that leg. So I'm using my arms to help. Okay, now we're going to do the other side. First lunge. Okay, other side. Take it back. Press that leg back. It. Keep going. Feel it in that opposing leg, feel it in that tush. All right, now we're going to take that band all the way down to the bottom of your feet, all the way underneath, okay? Open those feet up. Okay, so we're gonna go out, in, squat, bring it up. Out, in, down, bring it up. Good. Out, in, down, bring that knee up. Out, in, down, bring it up. Oh, out, in, down, bring it up. Sorry. Out, in, down, bring it up. So we're only gonna do that right side. I wanted to add a squat there that I didn't need to. It's just that one squat in the middle. There we go. Out, in, down, knee drive up. Out, in, down, bring it up. That's it. All right, so now we're gonna start all over. I'm gonna bring that band back up. Okay, side taps out. So side tap, side tap. In and out squats. There we go. Side taps out. That's it. Get it out there to the side. So use your arms if you need to. That's it. Get a little bit more action going there. How far can you step? Feeling it in that booty yet? I'm feeling it in that booty. Warming it up. That's it. Remember, you have that weight to the side, holding it to the side. All right, now we're going to take the weight, put it on the other side. If you're going to hold the weight, you don't need the weight for the third one because you got a lot of squatting going on there. Unless you just want to hold two weights while you're doing it. Right. Using those arms to help pump up the action. Good. Keep going. That's it. There you go. So we're going to do out squat, in squat, out squat, in squat. All right, so if you don't have have a band, you don't have to use a weight, unless you just want to hold weights for fun. Okay, out squat, in squat, out squat, in squat, good. Good job. Remember, knees have to follow toes as we're going up and down. The band sometimes makes you want to buckle those knees in. We've got to keep those knees apart. Don't lose your form. We have that extra resistance to cause us to push out a little bit while we're doing these squats. That's going to make us work those glutes just a little bit more. Okay, we're going to go reverse lunge. Press that knee back. A little split squat action. I have to bend my knee a little bit on this one, okay? Okay, so I'm going to go back. A little split squat. Work that glute on this side a little bit more. Don't want to saggy. Tush. Good job. You can feel that band working. Even if you didn't have a band, you could feel those muscles working, going back that quickly for those split squats. All right. I like the band too, because it helps you stay more balanced, I think. Other side. Okay, we're ready. Back. I like using the arms too, because they help you stay in a rhythm, and they help your legs to stay in a good upper body, lower body motion together. So it's good to use those arms to help keep you in a good motion. We're almost done here. So we only have the rest of this exercise. And after this, we're gonna go with the weight under and over the top of our shoes, okay? So under and over the top of the shoes. And we're gonna do this side now. So step out, step in, knee drive up. Bend the knees a little bit. Okay, so out, in, squat, knee drive up. Out, in, squat, knee drive up. Out, in, squat, knee drive up. Good. Whew. Gotta really make sure that your anchor leg is actually anchored, or when you try to pull that foot out, it wants to pull you away. Don't bring it in so close that you lose slack on the band. All right, we're gonna take the band off, we're done. The band, you can set that to the side. Now we're gonna get up and down off the mat here pretty soon. We're gonna use both weights next. Grab your water. So our next workout is also 12 minutes long, now to think about it. We have three standing, three laying down exercises next. Okay, are you ready? We're gonna do a standing fly, then we're gonna do one arm row on each side. Ready? So we're gonna work that back. Alrighty, so bend at the knees, just a little bit. Bend at the hips, come down, nice flat back. We're gonna bring both arms out. Both arms out. I'm going to work that back. Here we go. Next, in alignment with the spine. Try not to look up at your phone or your TV or your computer, whatever you're watching on. You're gonna look out a few feet in front of your feet, okay? And you're gonna just bring those weights out and back in. You can look up with your eyes only. Don't lift that chin. If you need to look at the screen for any reason, otherwise, just want you to do those back flies. Good. We don't want to hurt that neck at all. Pull in that belly button. Okay, so we're going to put one weight down. Okay, I'm going to take my right leg back. I'm going to rest my hand on my left leg. I'm going to drop my right arm just straight down from my shoulder. Okay, I'm going to skim that arm right back, right along the rib cage, and do my row. So it's times like this where you have to decide, do I have enough weight in my hands? Flies are a little bit harder, so you might use lighter weights to get that fly, but then when you're doing a one-arm row, maybe you need a heavier weight. So maybe you're doing 5 pounds with flies, maybe you need an 8 or a 10, or maybe even something heavier for a one-arm row. Because when I was doing this earlier, I was getting like 25 reps. Okay, now we're gonna switch. When ideally, I would want like 8 to 10 reps. So I would need a much, much heavier weight, which I can't really do right now, but because of my finger. But if I was really trying to transform my body, I would use a much, much heavier weight. But a lightweight is what I have. So I'm just gonna get as many reps in as I can during this time, which is also good. It'll work. But I always say heavier is better. If you can handle it with your grip, and you don't have any injuries that are causing you to not be able to use a heavier weight, and you actually own a heavier weight to be able to do this. So it's good to have a few extra weights. Okay, so we're gonna put the weights on the floor, and we're going to get on the floor. You're gonna put your hand out to the side, okay, and we're gonna put our knees here, and we're gonna flip our feet up and our elbow towards those ankles, okay? So this is just called a mermaid oblique crunch. And we're gonna do that nice little mermaid oblique crunch. So your feet are like your flippers. And we're just trying to get our elbow to our flippers. And then we're gonna flip over and do the other side here in a second. Good job. Good, okay, so now we're gonna flip over, or you can turn over, it's up to you, you know what the exercise is. Knees together, so we're not trying to lift those knees, okay, we're just flipping on those knees. Here we go. Now when I do this, one side feels totally different than the other side. So maybe you feel even, maybe you feel a little different one side than the other. You want to feel that little pinch right here, waistline. And then after this one, we're not going to get up yet. We're going to get onto our belly. Okay, and we're gonna do a Superman push-up. Okay, so we're going to start down here. We're gonna lift our feet up and our hands up. Feet up, hands up, and then we're gonna push ourselves into a push-up. Okay, plank,
So you can do knees, and you can go knees and then up, or you can just go straight up into your plank, okay? To your push-up. So many different variations. I just want you to try to get those hands up and those feet up, and then get into your push-up. Good job. Nice, all right. So now we're gonna start all over again, and we're gonna do that fly. So remember, knees, hips, we need to be bent over and up and down. That's it, out to that fly. Think about that neck. Let's bring that chin down a little bit so the neck's in alignment with the spine. Pull in that belly button, tight through those abs as we're lifting up through that back. Good job. One weight down. Okay, we're going to take that right leg back first, resting on the left leg. We're going to skim the elbow past the rib cage and back down. I kind of go fast up, slow down. Good. Kind of sound like a choo-choo train over here. Good job. Feels good. Now, if you get to a point, maybe you're doing a heavy weight and you've done your 8 or 10 reps and you still have time, then stop and take the extra time to rest. That's perfectly fine. You don't have to work the entire 45 seconds. Okay, now switch sides and let's do the other side here. Or you can do 8 reps, take a little rest, and do 8 more reps before the end of 45 seconds. Because maybe your weight's a little bit heavier. Good job. Keep going. Ready to hit the floor. All right. Set your weights to the side. Let's do those mermaid obliques. Arm out in front, out here, okay. Fingertips behind the ear. Make sure that shoulder's comfortable. Okay. Remember, we're crunching that upper body too. Just kind of bringing that elbow up towards those heels. As we're bringing those feet up, bending from the knees. Swing around into the other side. Out we go. Knees are ready. My little flippers ready. That's it. Consistency. Not starving yourself. It's probably one of the worst things that you can do because your body goes into stress. Drinking plenty of water. Eat good food. Your body wants you to eat. And eating good food, good protein, good vegetables. All right, last exercise in this round. All right, let's lift up into our Superman first. And then your body will release the fat that it needs to and start to build the muscle that it needs in order for you to change your metabolism. And you'll get a leaner, stronger body. That's what you want. You're not going to get a bulky body by using weight. You would have to use, okay, you're not going to. I mean, it's just not possible. The people that you see in those pictures, those women, I mean, they spend hours and hours and hours in the gym and take things to make them look that way, and you're not doing that, so it's not going to happen. So lifting an 8-pound weight over a 5-pound weight is not going to give you a manly body. It's not going to happen. All right, so we have one more set of exercises to do. So we're going to start on the mat. And we're going to start with a chest press and a bridge. And then we're going to do, of course, 5 more exercises after that. So we worked our back last time, so we're going to work our chest this time. And abs, chest and abs this time. So, out to the side, you know me, I like those chest and ab exercises. They're great. So, push the feet away from you. Don't have them right up next to your tush. That's a little bit easier. Elbows way out to the side, looking up. Nice flat back. We're going to lift the tush and bring the weights up above, okay? I like to balance on the heels, lift the toes up. So I work the back of the legs a little bit more and that tush, and I pull in the belly button as I bring the weights up over the head. Good. Pull those abs in. Good job. All right, so now we're going to go ahead, bring that weight behind us, and we're going to extend the legs out, and we're going to bring that weight up to bent knees. That's the last time those heels are going to touch the ground, last time the weight's going to touch the ground, so we're going to crunch and extend. So think about what those shoulders are telling you. Do they like going behind your head? So think about that arc that you're doing. That's a little high. There you go. So I want those legs to go, you know, about 6 to 12 inches above the ground. There we go. Now, if your weight is too light, you're welcome to grab the other weight as it goes behind your head. Ready, and then we're gonna grab this weight, okay? And we're gonna bring our legs up. So we're gonna do scissor legs with a fly. So one leg will come up, one leg will come down. So we bring it up and down. Excellent. All right. So we're going to do a sit-up with a punch next. Okay, sit up, and we're going to punch and come back down. And then we're going to bring ourselves over and we're going to get one weight, bring it out in front, okay? Bring ourselves into a plank, okay? We're going to jump up, jump back, and we're going to bring our weight out, touch the toe, okay? Up, back, touch the toe, touch the toe. Touch the toe, up, back, touch the toe, back, touch the toe, touch the toe, up, back, touch the toe. And then we're going to go ahead, and I like these ones where we're on our knees. We're going to hold one weight, and we're going to come down, okay, down, up, and drive the car, down, up, drive the car, down, up, drive the car, good. Job. All right, so let's go back and we're going to start with our chest press and our bridge. Push those feet away. Chest press on the bridge. Squeeze that tush. Pull that belly button in. Squeeze the chest. Get those elbows out nice and far. All right, so one weight behind your head and extend those legs out so you can bring the weight above the knees and you have your little crunch.
shoulder raise. Get those shoulders and abs at the same time. Good, now we're gonna do the fly with the leg raised. So both legs up. So one goes down and then the other one goes down as the other one comes up. So we go down and up. There we go. So as the arms go up and down, the legs switch places. And the heel just gently taps the mat. Oh, all righty. Okay, so we're gonna do a sit up with a punch. So now we're going to take ourselves back into our plank with our toe tap. With our little thruster. Okay. Thruster up and back. Toe tap. Switch hands. Toe tap. Up, back. Toe tap. Toe tap. Get back into that plank. Up, back. Toe tap, plank, toe tap, plank, back, toe tap, plank, toe tap, plank, back, toe tap, plank, toe tap, plank, back, toe tap, plank, toe tap, plank, up, back. All right. And, okay, so we're going to get ready for our last exercise. So get down on those knees, get ready. Okay, remember, we never get this low again. We're going to get up and we're going to drive the car. Ready, set, go. Up, drive the car. Up, drive the car. All right, and that's the end of our workout. All right, so get yourself a drink of water.
And we're going to do our 5 minute cool down. Okay, let's get ourselves here. Get yourself into a crisscross position just to start with. And we're going to go side to side. Take nice deep breaths in and out. Get those weights out of the way. There we go. Good, okay, interlace those fingers and drop the chin. And just hold yourself here for a second. Rounding the back. Don't smush the chin into the chest. Okay, inhale, exhale. Go ahead and bring the hands up. So we're not bringing them all the way over the head, just out in front a little ways. Lifting the chin a little bit. Lifting the eyes a little bit more. Inhale, exhale, all the way around. So we're going to bring the hands so the fingertips are touching the floor. And we're going to lift the chin and the chest a little bit more. And then we're going to inhale, exhale, bring yourself forward, release the hands. You're going to grab onto the front of your legs and you're going to lean back. You're going to tuck in the chin a little bit, not bringing it to your chest. You're going to just really round the back, pull in the belly button. Nice deep breaths. Inhale, exhale, you're going to slowly pull yourself back up. Let's go ahead and bring one leg over, make yourself into like a little pretzel here. Make sure that bottom hip is happy, top hip is happy. We're just going to rotate to the side just a little bit, as far as you can go. So if this doesn't feel good, get yourself into a position that you're happy in, that you're going to get your hips. Maybe you need to straighten this bottom leg out. And then we're going to trade sides. Just try to get deep into those hips from all those squats. And now we're going to go ahead and extend those legs out in front. So extend those legs out in front. Big inhale. Exhale, forward fold, okay? So you're going to come forward, and we're just going to keep that back straight. I'm just grabbing onto my ankles, looking out in front of my toes. And I'm going to inhale, round the back. Exhale, sit up nice and tall. Roll the shoulders down and back. Good job. I'm going to lift my hand up nice and tall. And then bring it back down. Lift my hand up nice and tall. And then bring it back down. Roll the shoulders down and back. Good job. Fingertips behind the ear. Roll my elbows back. Sit up nice and tall. Good. Watching that posture. Now push the elbows back. Little tiny pulses. Thinking about that posture. Watching that back. Always thinking about that posture. We want to stay nice and erect. We want to make sure that we don't slump. People look at their cell phones and their tablets and you read. You want to make sure that you watch that posture. All right, inhale, exhale, oh, release those hands. Excellent, bring those legs back in. We're going to go ahead and take a rotation to the side. Inhale, Inhale, exhale, all the way to the other side. And then bring yourself back to center. Let's crisscross those arms and round the back. Drop in that chin, pull in that belly button. Big breath, fill that back up. Exhale. Slowly lift the chin. Now, recross those arms, other arms on top. Drop the chin. Big inhale. Exhale. Exhale. Big inhale. Exhale. Slowly raise that chin back up. Okay, shake out those arms. Rotate the wrists. Open and close the hands. Okay, cat's claws. All right, this is Joy from Enjoy Fitness 43. Thank you for being with me today. I hope you enjoyed our workout. I'll see you next week. Have a great day.